Coach Mears, congratulations, first of all. I know you came off a real big weekend.
Yeah.
So tell us your thoughts, first of all, about putting this match on a Monday after a huge weekend. I mean, emotionally, physically, everything, just to come in here. I know the backyard brawl is a huge thing for Derry Latrobe, but how did that impact your squad, you know, coming off the weekend that you did, which was a huge King of the Mountain tournament, which you had much success at, but how is it hard to get up on a Monday for this, huh?
Well, we talked about that. I knew this was going to be a grind for him. I said, guys, we're going to come home. We have to work out Sunday. I don't want to do it to you, but we have no choice. We got to make weight. I did bump a couple guys a little, so Vinny didn't have to suck down again and Jack didn't have to suck down. Try to help those guys because they have such a long road ahead of them, you know, into March.
Sure.
Borio's a little luckier. He's more of a natural 215. But I told him, I said, look, this is adversity. It's going to test you a little bit. I said, there's nothing we can do about it. You don't even get a pound. So we're going to go in there. We're going to wrestle. And I said, if you think too much about it and dwell on it, you're going to wrestle worse. Right now it's Latrobe. It's Derry. It's almost Christmas break. I said, when you're over tonight, you get a breather. Let's just get it done. Focus one bout at a time. And I said, you're going to learn when you get to Hershey, you might be in a WrestleBacks wrestling three times.
Right.
And nobody feels sorry for you. So to me, it was a little bit of a character building thing.
Yeah, and that's the right and perfect attitude, I think. I agree with you. And it's those kind of things that they have to work through, especially to do the things that you want to do and the schedule that you have this season. That's a good test coming off of a weekend. It's always hard to get up on a Monday, but having a match maybe was a little bit easier because, hey, it's Latrobe, it's Derry. So talk a little bit about, if you will, maybe what your bright spots were tonight. I know that we all discussed this earlier. Derry's bringing in a younger squad, and you had sort of high expectations and sort of typical expectations of what you thought would happen in the match, but did anything happen that you were really pleased with?
I was very pleased with Bowers' match. You know, he's very even with that kid. I thought our conditioning was good there. I thought Lucas Braun's coming on. You know, he did a nice job at 45 against Panicelli. And even Austin Latiker, I sent Leo Joseph. You know, I was thinking maybe they would take the matchup, but Austin's the kid that's going to be the guy in there eventually, maybe next year. You know, our lineup's not quite done yet.
Sure.
A lot of people know we have Nate Roth about ready.
Yep.
Once Bronson can drop down to 47, that's where he's certified at. You know, it adjusts us a little bit stronger than we are now. And they are young, but we have great leadership. You know, Pletcher, Kilcarry, Borio, they lead these kids. They let them in a locker room. They told them their expectations as leaders.
Sure.
And that's great in high school sports. You don't always get that.
You know,
and those guys could easily just care about themselves, but they don't. You saw Vinny walking them down the bench, talking to each kid, telling them stay in the zone, you know. So I'm blessed to have that type of leadership, and I was glad. I kind of let them lead them through this tonight. Let them lead their team through a tough night of adversity. Bond a little bit as a leadership to your team, and I thought they did that.
Yeah. But I know, Coach, going into the match, you said, you know, some of the keys to success were, one, you wanted your guys to be aggressive, right? And two, you shared with me that the goal going into the match was 4 to 5 pins. I think you got 6 or 7 tonight. So is that something that you're going to go and review and talk with the guys about and say, hey, you know, we hit this goal or we hit this mark? Or is that just something that, you know, your leaders are already probably back there talking about the team already?
Yeah, no, we absolutely have goals. We will discuss it. We have a chart in our wrestling room that we figured out roughly, counted our schedule. If we could pin 180 people, we'd have a shot of being WPL champs, just the way it would set us up for our accomplishments. And we didn't want to get pinned 50 times this year. And what I'm trying to teach them as a good dual meet team, which I believe we are, we're actually probably a better dual meet team than a tournament team right now until we get some guys back. But when you can move Vinny, Kilcarry, and Pletcher around, and those Borea, those kind of guys, you should pin. And I keep telling them, a pin is two decisions. You're making it easier for your younger guys. You're racking up the bonus points. Now, if they just get majored, you won 6-4. The next one gets majored, win 6-4. I said, you got to be a pinning team to be a great dual meet team. So their goal was 4 or 5 a night. I said, you go up 30-0 after 5 matches. I like our odds every single night. I don't care if it's Nazareth. I don't care if it's Northampton. Yeah, I like our odds.
Yeah, I see your team being very solid when you get a Nate Roth back in the lineup.
Yeah.
Very impressed with your squad. Tell us what you have coming up now going into the Christmas break. Obviously, Powerade is going to be the big one right after. What do you have on your schedule here coming up other than you have a section match Wednesday, right?
No, we actually don't.
You have the bye week this week.
So that was actually one thing fell right for us.
Yeah.
One thing fell right for us. We do have that bye week. So I am going to condition hard tomorrow, I told him. Yeah, because when you wrestle a lot, you lose a little bit of conditioning. It's not your fault. You're just not in a room enough.
Right.
And get off the mat tomorrow. We'll do a lot of conditioning for an hour or so. Then get back to the mat a little Wednesday and then give him Christmas Eve, Christmas Day off. And then we'll get focused on Powerade. Because once we hit January, we have a match Wednesday with Hempfield Counties, right to Norwin Tuesday and fly to Colorado that next Thursday. So it only gets tougher for us, but we set it to be this way, and we firmly believe at the end of the year, once Nate's in and we're adjusted down, we're pretty solid. I think we can go with just about anybody. So we're going to give it a run and see what happens.
Now, do you have a percentage on the chances that Nate Roth will be in the lineup for Powerade?
Nate, zero.
Zero.
I can tell you that, zero. I think Nate, he's ready. He's released. I just worry in a 66 team tournament, the stamina of him.
Throwing him
I mean, I don't care how good you are.
Right.
You got to go through that 2-day grind. And I don't want to do that to him first thing out of the gate.
Right. You know, so you run the risk of losing him down the road when you really need him.
War when we just won the battle to get him back.
Yeah.
He's much more important to me at the Hempfield match, at the Norwin match, in the playoffs in Colorado, and most importantly for his sake. You saw what happened the last couple of years with the injury and the slam.
Right.
Nate's probably the best kid in the state no one knows about because he could have placed there twice in the top four and hasn't been there yet. I said it's very critical for him to get on the podium in Hershey. That's the podium I want him on. Powerade, next year. He's our new junior.
Right. Yeah, he's got a lot more to bring to the table.
Yeah, but I can tell you it's zero.
All right.
Well, there you go.
Signed, sealed, and delivered.
That's Coach Mears bringing up his Latrobe Wildcats this evening. Victorious in the away gym, 65-3. Look forward to, and I'm glad you mentioned about your Colorado trip. I wanted our viewers to know, you know, that didn't have a chance to watch the kickoff show about what a nice thing that is you have planned for your team coming up after the counties.
Yeah, we're going to fly out, and the 14th, the Friday, we're going to wrestle Pomona, Colorado. They're two-time defending big school state champs, and Monarch, another powerhouse school, in a tri meet Friday night. And then Saturday, we're going to wrestle the Western Arvada Open, which is where Pueblo County and all those teams that come to Ironman and Beast will be in there. So we're going to wrestle in the Midwest for a weekend, and then we're going to fly home Sunday, and then we get a week to down cycle a little, get healthy, and then it's 26th, our playoff start. So hopefully when that plane lands, they're all grown up and ready to go.
That's a good attitude,
that
right,
is a
George?
Great attitude.
That's the one you hope happens, too. So, right. Coach Mears, congratulations on the evening.
Thank you. Congratulations, Coach.
Enjoy it and take some well-deserved and needed rest right now.
Yeah, it's Christmas cookie time.
Yeah, right?
Have a good holiday, Coach.
Merry Christmas.
Okay.